Welcome to Garden City Church, a place where you can belong before you believe. This week, George gives us a message about the steps we can take on our spiritual journeys to get closer to Jesus. If you'd like to partner with us here at the channel, there's three ways you can do that. You can like and subscribe, you can share this video with a friend, or you can partner with us financially. You can do that by going to our website or mailing us a check. We love all of you so much. Let's get into that word with George.
The stories we live have an impact on the stories of our life. The Bible has a big narrative, a large story that it's telling, and I like to break it down really simply with these three parts of the story: the garden blessed, the garden broken, and the garden becoming new. Now, the garden blessed, there was a good God who created a good world, and everything was good and blessed, and there was harmony. There was the Bible calls like a shalom, a flourishing, where everything is in right relationship. And then the garden was broken. The original humans made a decision. It kind of took a left turn, and there was a fragmenting or shattering of that blessing and that blessed state, that harmony between all things and relationships between humans and the planet, and especially with God. There's a fracture that occurred, but God did not abandon his good creation. He worked for its good, and especially in the moment that Jesus was sent, Jesus is this pivotal moment where God began doing a work that was moving a garden broken toward a garden becoming new. And we ultimately know that in the scriptures that God is going to make all things new, and the garden becoming new and good is really leading to this flourishing garden city. So that's the large story just broken down into three parts. There's a verse in Jeremiah that I think is so important to remind us as humans to be working with God for the peace, for the flourishing of our world. It says this: work for the flourishing of the city that I have sent you to. Pray to the Lord for that city. If it flourishes, you too will flourish. I believe people long to move away from the broken garden and toward the garden becoming new. I believe people want to live a life where they can find acceptance, where they can grow, they can become, and they can become healthy, and ultimately where they can really connect with the source of life, God. People are looking for a life of flourishing. Now, at Garden City, our church, our goal is to help people join Jesus on a journey toward wholeness, toward flourishing, personal flourishing and cultural flourishing, personal wholeness and cultural wholeness. It's why we exist. Now, we have three essential steps on this spiritual journey with Jesus that we always come back to at Garden City: belong, believe, and be love. Now, belong. This is, we're trying to create a community of belonging that allows people to experience and explore the way of Jesus before they believe in Jesus, or as they believe in Jesus. Rather than focusing on who's in and who's out, we choose to focus on people and what they're moving toward, and we try to keep Jesus at the center. We focus on helping people of all backgrounds, all cultures and perspectives to feel welcome, to experience community right where they're at, and move forward on their spiritual journey toward Jesus. Whether you're exploring faith, deconstructing, reconstructing, reframing your faith, whatever, we want to help you belong before you believe, and maybe belong as you believe. Another key step is believe. Believing is learning and turning our lives to trust Jesus, to listen to Jesus' voice over others, over all others, and to see the world as Jesus does, and to be in the world the way Jesus wants us to be in it. When we trust and listen and learn from the Spirit of Christ, we begin to see God at work in the brokenness of our world. We begin to see God's grace in all the grit. And our job is to see what he's doing and to figure out how to join him, how to align our lives with him. And the more we reflect on God's love in our world, the more we begin to reflect God's love to our world. So believing is a huge step. Now, the last step or last value that we really emphasize on this journey is be love, learning to be love. We are blessed to be a blessing. I believe we're loved to be love where we live. When we turn toward Jesus, he turns us toward others to love and serve them. Jesus didn't come to be served, but to serve others. And when we practice being love, it's learning that way of service and stewardship. Every person has been given a calling, a purpose for their life by the Lord. Now, as a community, we want to help people find belonging and then their calling so that we can send and support them to be love right where they live, serving the common good of their community, their neighborhood, their workplace, their friends, their family. Christians through the ages have been sent into their world to be love in all of these places and help people move forward toward flourishing, toward Jesus, in a way that makes them more human, not less, more like the image bearers they were designed to be by God and not less like that. A step of learning to be love is a step of becoming a steward of the gardens of our lives, stewards of the people and the circles of influence and relationships that we've been given. In this way, we learn to steward and be love. And I want to invite you to participate in this vision together. This vision doesn't matter unless we're moving together toward flourishing and helping one another. Life's not easy, and this journey that we're on isn't easy. And I know that we all can be coming from very unique places, but it's so much better when we do it together. So I want to encourage you to take at least one action step today. These steps help us join Jesus on that journey toward wholeness and toward flourishing. So here's the three action steps: a step of belonging, a step of believing, or a step of being love. Now with belonging, maybe ask this question: in what ways might Jesus be calling you to belong and help others to belong? Now we have some simple ways within our church to help garner belonging. We want to encourage people to start or join a group. In our groups, you can ask, you know, the deeper questions of life and grow on your spiritual journey together and ask some of the questions that you are really kind of struggling or working through. I just think that's so important. Start or join a group. Two other ways, we have something called Starting Point. It's a really great space for people who are new or maybe coming back to faith, and we get to hear your story. You get to hear a little bit of our story, and we just talk about next steps. And then the other great spot for belonging is our Growth Track. And it's just that. It helps give tools and build relationships that help us grow in this vision, in this Jesus-centered vision together. So those are some ways that we offer for belonging. A step of belief. Let me ask you this. What is Jesus asking you to let go of? And what is he asking you to trust him for in your life right now? This is a step of trust. Some ways that we see people take steps of trust is just beginning to move toward Jesus and trust his teaching, to receive forgiveness and freedom for their life and beginning a journey with Jesus. That is a huge step of trust. Some others, it's taking that step of getting baptized, which is going public in your faith. It's such an important moment, and it symbolizes so much in our relationship with God. Another way, maybe a step of trust, simply might be just engaging on Sundays with us in person, and really beginning to engage on that level and being with your community weekly or online. If you're part of our online community, that's a step of trust, just making it consistent in your life. Those are a few examples of ways that we can begin trusting Jesus together. And then lastly, a step to be love. I think an important question for this is, how is God calling you to be love these days? How is God calling you to steward and cultivate the gardens of your life, your family, friends, neighborhood, your work? You know, and what people has he placed in your life to do that with and to partner with? We have some incredible ways within our church to help us practice being love. We do this within community. So again, getting in a group or starting a group, I think, is so important. All of our groups usually serve somewhere, and we have some great partnerships. One of our key partnerships is with the foster care community. And we have a really amazing program we do during Christmas called One Child. We've got some other opportunities to partner with the foster care community. And so there's just some amazing things like that. Then we have our Sunday ministries, which are incredible ways to be loved together. We have teams that serve Garden City Kids or worship, guest services to help people feel loved and accepted. We've got setup teams, and we always want to help people learn how to lead and grow and lead groups themselves. And so all of this requires generosity, and we want to really cultivate generosity in our church and through our church. And that's helping people to learn how to wisely give their time, talent, and treasure for the growth of God's kingdom. So generosity is a big way of learning to be love together. And I want to invite you toward that. There's so many benefits to this journey. We can gain wisdom on this journey with Jesus. I think we experience joy on this journey. We discover our gifts and other people's gifts and our deeper calling and sense of purpose. We actually begin developing deeper and healthier relationships on this journey. And we can actually create a community where we can challenge one another and ask deep questions. And then we become healthier people, because I think this is a holistic approach to faith and life. It cares about the multiple dimensions of the human, from, you know, our emotional health and spiritual health to community health, just as a few examples, but it's holistic. And then I'd say just a few more things. I think that some other benefits to this journey is just the growth and change into the person that you long to become. This works toward that end. This helps us in a safe and loving community. And then you leave a legacy impact. Your love lasts. When you give, when you serve, when you steward, there's a lasting impact on people. And then you begin to develop a deeper life with Jesus, a life deeply connected to God, the source of all life. Jesus said this in John 5:24. I tell you the truth. Those who listen to my message and believe in God who sent me have eternal life. What would keep you from taking a step past the barriers that have prevented you from moving forward? What would keep you from moving toward the life that God has intended for you? I want to invite you to take that step of trust right now, a step of commitment, belonging, believing, or learning to be love. If you're ready to take that step, would you just pray this prayer as an action of the heart to say, I am taking this step. Pray with me. Jesus, I am taking this step of faith today. I trust you. I thank you. Thank you for going to the cross to provide forgiveness and freedom and life for me. Thank you for your teachings that show us the way of life. The best I know how, I take this step of trust toward you on my journey today. I love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, I'm so excited for what God's doing in our church and through our church. I'm excited for you. And we're taking our steps together, all on our unique journeys, of course, but we're doing this together. So make sure you're not doing this alone. I want to invite you to something special. Next week, we're starting our new series called Finding Good in the Neighborhood. And this sermon series is going to be all about finding and cultivating the grace and goodness of God in our neighborhoods, the places we live life. Join us and invite someone else who might not have come before to join us. You have nothing to lose and everything to gain by spending just a little bit of time over this sermon series, learning to seek the good together. Guys, I love you. I'll see you all next week.
Got the world upon my shoulders, but you've been saying, child, put it down.
I prayed and prayed that you would take my burden, but you keep saying, child, put it down.
Maybe I'm addicted to the worry. Maybe I'm a slave to holding on. Help me put it down. Help me put it down.